Welcome to the video tutorial on using census data in Excel. I am Alexandra Barker, Data Dissemination Specialist with the Census Bureau. During this tutorial, you will learn about data access using the American FactFinder and table formatting in Excel. One easy way to access data from the Census Bureau is to use the American FactFinder, or for short, AFF. The American FactFinder is an online, self-service tool designed to search a variety of demographic, socioeconomic, housing, and business data. After we download data from the American FactFinder, we will use the Excel to manipulate the data. Excel is a familiar tool to many people. They use it every day. Excel can be leveraged to unlock the value of open data of all kinds, and is particularly well-suited to transforming, analyzing, and visualizing census data. This course will show how to use Excel to format your data. Now let's go to the American FactFinder. So from census.gov, all you have to do is click on the data menu and select data tools and apps, and just click on the American FactFinder. The American FactFinder provides three ways for you to search for your data. Community Facts gives you access to basic information along with the most popular tables about an area. You can also follow the steps provided by the guided search feature. It lets you narrow down to the most popular and detailed tables. You can use the advanced search to build a query. It gives you access to all datasets and features available in the American FactFinder. In all cases, the data from this tool can be modified prior to being downloaded. We'll start by looking at Community Facts to find your data. When you click on Community Facts, you are able to enter a single geography. It could be a state, a county, a city, town, or zip code. United States is the default. Then you can click on any of the topics to see the estimates. So let's say that for our example today, you want to see the population growth or decline in the US. You can click on Population and then choose any of the sources for population data. Let's choose the 2016 population estimates. You have a single estimate here for the population of the US, but you also have some suggested tables related to the topic. Let's click on the annual population estimates right here on the bottom. So now you have a view of the population estimates table for the United States, with trends over time of population in the country. You also have multiple years available. For example, when we bring into Excel, let's say we want to look at data for every county, not just the US, for the past 6 years. So you're going to need to add more geographies. The only way to add more geographies is now to move from the Community Facts into the Advanced Search option of the American FactFinder. So let's do that by clicking in Advanced Search. And I'm going to start a brand new search. If you click and continue, it will import the default geography, which is the US right now. I'm just going to have a brand new search here. And the advanced search feature will allow me to add as many geographies as I would like to my query. So we'll start by selecting the geography option. Once you click in geography, from the list tab, I can select the geographic level I want to work from. In this case, let's look at all counties in the US. So I click in county, and I don't have to select the state since I want all counties in the US. Once I click in all counties within the US, I can add them to my selections or to my shopping basket, as I like to call it. So now I can close the geography search, and you have all the tables available for this geography. From the first few tables, I have all the population estimates. You can see the source here on the right. And I'm just going to check the annual estimates of the resident populations of April 1st, 2010 to July 1st, 2016. It's exactly the same table we accessed through Community Facts. However, now, as you'll see, I have all the geographies that I selected available, not only the US. So here are all the counties in the US. A very extensive list that we'll be able to see it better in Excel. So one of the many benefits of using Excel is that it can be used to easily transform your data. In this case, we're going to start modifying our table using the census tools, and then we'll put the finishing touches on the structure using Excel. You can do all of this in Excel, but this example shows some useful methods of cleaning up the data before you download. So let's do that. So you see now a table with the April 2010 census data and all the yearly population estimates. So let's say we only want to download the yearly estimates excluding the April 1st, 2010 columns right here. So I go to Modify Table, and it will allow you to uncheck the option Census and Estimate Base. We won't need that because we're only going to be looking at the columns with each individual year. And then I leave all the counties alone, so just a very basic modification. So once you're done modifying your table, you can just download it. Just click Use the Data and leave both box checked. Click OK. And once the download is ready, you get your zip file. So I'm just going to open. And always choose the file that shows with annotation. This is the only way you're going to get the table with all the details, the applicable details. So it's a best practice to get in the habit of saving your file as a workbook right away. So let's first do that. So go to File, Save As, find the right spot in your computer. So I have my right folder here. I change to Excel Workbook. And then just choose a title. In this case, I'm choosing Pop Estimates 1, which I already had saved there. So I'm just going to replace that file. And now we can start modifying. So first thing, let's clean up by removing the columns and rows, which we don't need. We won't need the GUIDs. So let's right away remove the GUIDs. We also won't need this row here, the field name. So let me delete this one as well. So once you remove the unnecessary columns and rows, just make sure it's all looking right. You can format this as table. So let's select the range we need for our table and just click on Format as Table. Choose any style. So I'm picking this one. Always check My Table has headers and click OK. You notice that it gives arrows next to the headers. Click on the arrows and you see options for sorting and filtering your data. This all comes with being formatted as a table. This can be very useful in finding specific information. For example, let's say you want to find population data for Cook County. So all you have to do here is just start searching and type Cook. But wait, there are several counties with Cook in their names, and you just wanted the one for Cook County, Illinois. It would be better if the state were in its own column, separate from the county. That way, you could filter the state to Illinois and the county to Cook. So let's do a very common transformation with census data. So let's break up a cell into multiple cells. So we start by cancel and click on the column B. And just insert a brand new column. What you have to do next is just select the column that you are breaking into two different categories. And you go to the data menu and select text to columns. And you can set up the parameters from here. So you see that you have some options for how you really want to split up the column. You can use a delimiter, meaning that Excel should split up the column based on a character. In this case, it will be a common. Or you can use a fixed width, which you sometimes need for data coming of a legacy system like mainframes. But in this case, we are delimited by the common that separates the county from the states. So all I have to do now is click Next and make sure common is selected. You don't have to remove tab. It's really up to you. But just click Next again. And then click Finish. and then click OK, and now you see that your state is no longer sharing the same column with the county name, so you have two separate columns right now. Let's rename this column to state. Here we go. Now you can do things like analyzing population data change for a single state. For example, let's say we just want to see data for the state of Hawaii. So I can go here in the state and start typing Hawaii. And you see now your table is only going to show the rows that are associated with the state of Hawaii. You now have a fully functioning table, yet another best practice is to name your table. This will make it obvious which data you're referring to when you do more advanced things like working with formulas and maps. To name this table, simply click on the Design tab, so here we go, and change the table name. This concludes our overview about census data using the American FactFinder and table formatting in Excel. For more video tutorials, visit census.gov and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget to follow us on social media. Thank you.